That's the perfect time for rain. End of the weekend is the perfect
exactly.
time for rain.
Exactly. So it just rains all weekend. Perfect, Greg. Thanks so much.
Nice. All right, guys. Well, the jig is up. Get it? Riverdance jig.
Got it.
After 16 years of wowing audiences with their fast footwork and Irish charm, the original U.S. tour of Riverdance closes this summer.
The show makes its last North Texas appearance tonight and tomorrow at the Music Hall at Fair Park. And joining us now is lead dancer Mark Moyles and his wife and fellow cast member, Niamh O'Connor. Guys, how are you today?
Good, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
The good news is there's still performances left, so audiences can still come and enjoy the show. What does it mean for you guys to be part of the farewell tour?
Oh, well, Niamh and I have had the pleasure of touring with this production for over 15 years now. So it's bittersweet because, as you know, Riverdance is coming to an end here in North America, which is sad for all of us because we really enjoy touring in North America because it's so easy and the audiences are the best in the world. But Riverdance is going to continue just to new countries that we haven't been to before, like South America.
India,
South Africa. So Riverdance will continue. It's just finishing here in North America.
And it's specifically this show production that is discontinuing. That's, there could be other possibles in the future. We don't know.
Yes.
Let's right. talk about the
15 years, right?
15 years is amazing.
How old are you guys?
They both started when they were 3 and a half.
I know. I'm like, wow, that's a long time to do a show, isn't it?
It is.
You guys are tired.
And Niamh, you were actually at the premiere in Dublin, the world premiere, correct? You performed in?
That's right, in 1995. The 9th of February, so our anniversary is coming up soon. So it was, you know, for an Irish dancer, this was the first ever Irish dance show. So it was very exciting for all of us as young dancers, you know, dancing all our lives, to go into a show and be a professional dancer for the first time.
Do you feel like you guys are ambassadors? Because you're both from Dublin originally, correct?
Yes.
Do you feel like you guys are ambassadors for the Irish culture? Because what is the show about for those that don't know? We see the river dancing, we see all the amazing dancing, but there's a story behind this. The story is, you tell
us. The first half of the show is mainly about the myths and legends of Irish culture. And the second half is the departure and discovery after the famine, where we went, how other cultures influenced us, and how we influenced other cultures. So that's mainly the theme behind Riverdance. But like you said, yes, we very much so look at ourselves as cultural ambassadors, and with that comes great responsibility. But it's something we really, really enjoy, and to get to bring your culture around the world is not something that everybody gets to do.
And
doing something you love to do. We go to work every day, but we're going to work to do something we absolutely love doing.
Yeah, right.
And you guys are both in amazing shape. I can't even imagine the leg muscles that it takes to do this. How many calories do you think you burn in one show?
I don't know. They did a study on us one time, actually.
Did they?
Interesting enough. Yeah, we were losing about 5 pounds a night.
What?
Mainly
I am in the wrong business, people.
Yeah. Mainly
I
that's
think I might have
weight,
one of
you've got a river dance.
And river dance it. Wow.
I can only imagine. I mean, because you are dancing the whole time.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right. So, but most of that is water weight. And they judge it now, so that they try and make us finish the show at the exact same weight we started the show.
Oh my gosh, okay, so the tour is ending. Yeah. So you guys go and get office jobs and become sedentary. What happens to you after the show is closed?
Well, most of us would have either gone to college at this stage and studied whatever it is you wanted to do prior to Riverdance. But for the likes of myself and Niamh, who joined it when we were 17, 18 years of age, because we didn't think Riverdance had a 17-year longevity in it. So for us, we went on to do our teacher's examinations to be able to teach Irish dancing.
Oh, wow.
So also studying sports psychology and things like that.
A passing of the baton of sorts.
Exactly.
You teach the next generation to kind of take over where you left off.
Sports psychology, do you use that in your dancing?
Absolutely.
You
absolutely.
Do? In what way?
Having done it for this long, anyway, for both myself and Niamh, it gets to the point where you kind of say to yourself at some point, is this what I want to continue to do?
Right.
Mm-hmm. And I knew it was, but I needed a new edge. I needed something new to help me continue to stay motivated, and it was sports psychology that I
Can you talk to the Cowboys while you're here?
Teach them some river dance. They need to dance or something.
Sports
now,
psychology.
You two actually are husband and wife. How did the two of you meet, first of all?
Well, we met in Riverdance, obviously, but we actually grew up around the corner from each other in Dublin.
Did you really?
Yeah. Our parents knew each other. I knew Padraic's sister, but Padraic's a couple of years younger than me, so he wouldn't have been hanging around with us at that stage. But they emigrated to New York when he was 8, so I hadn't seen him or his family for a long time. And every time I was in the European company and Padraic was in the American company touring, and my mom used to always say, "Do you ever see Padraic, Moyles?" And his mom used to say, "Do you ever see Niamh O'Connor?" Then we were like, "No, he's in a different company." And then eventually I was transferred to the American show and we finally met. And
we were, fate took over.
Well, we were friends for a long time, and then, you know, he finally won me over.
Oh, that's a great Valentine's
Day
story.
As we end this here segment, maybe you could teach us a little ditty.
Yes, we need to know how to river dance.
Yeah.
Come on.
This Kent Baker dress was made for river dance.
Now, Niamh has the heels on, so she can't
I'll
wait a minute.
Okay, you tell us what
you're doing. I have heels on. You don't care about my well-being.
But you don't have to perform in river dance tonight.
All right,
tonight.
Okay.
She does.
Good call.
Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to try and start with our feet turned out.
Yeah,
and we're gonna
do I need space here?
No. We're not going
to tie you. No, you guys need to stand close because I fall. You're going down with me.
So we'll go 5, 6, 7 and stamp on 8. That's it. And then you're going to switch onto your left foot. Good. And onto your right foot.
And well, there's a brush little step, foot. Kind of like a brush.
Exactly. Yep. So let's try it all together. 5, 6, 7, stamp. Left, right, left, up. He's got it right away. He's joining the show tonight.
He does. Ty, people don't know this about Ty, but he's a good dancer.
You love
he enjoys dancing.
Oh, you're
like he
smile.
Would be a backup dancer in a heartbeat for some big band. Isn't
not
that
a
right?
Dancer?
I would. I'm focused on my river dance.
He's more of a backup dancer. Maybe we could teach those penguins over there to dance. Guys, this has been really fun. Hearing your story is really great, and people can still see you tonight and tomorrow night at the Music Hall at Fair Park. There's only 3 shows, and we have all the details on our website.
All right, up next, we have the folks and the critters.